Hello friends, today we will study pointer to 1D arrays in C programming. Content of our today's sessions are pointer to 1D arrays. For this, we'll require recall the concept of pointers in C programming. Then we'll go for pointer to 1D arrays. At the end of this session, you will be able to understand the concept of pointers to arrays. You will make efficient use of pointers and you will be confident about use of pointers in C. Before starting for pointer to 1D arrays, we'll recollect the concept of pointers in C. Here, diagram explains two variable declaration, where the first variable is nothing but I is declared over here with the value 3, which is assigned to I. J is another variable and it is holding some address location. So obviously J must be a pointer type variable, which is pointing to the address location 65524. So it is a variable that contains the address of another variable. How to declare a pointer type variable? Declaration is with the help of asterisk symbol, integer, star or asterisk j. It is also called as a pointer j. How to assign a address of a variable to pointer type variable j? It is assigned with the help of ampersand symbol. Address of I is assigned with the help of assignment operator to the variable j. We need to remember one thing. J is not any ordinary integer type variable, but it is a pointer type variable. Therefore, it holds an address of another ordinary variable. As j is holding the address of I, that is 65524. Other way around, we can say that J is pointing to I. Now let's start with the pointer to 1D arrays. First of all, let's see how to implement pointers to 1D arrays. The example is given over here. All the tasks we can do with the help of base address of the array. Base address of the array is nothing but the starting address of the array. By assigning that base address to a pointer type variable, we can implement pointer to 1D arrays. Here we'll see the example. A array is declared, 5 values are assigned, J is a pointer type variable. Here the data type of the variable whose address we are going to store in a pointer type variable J, the data type of both the variable is matching over here. It should match, otherwise it will not work. So the data type of which the address we are going to store in a pointer type variable J and its data type, both are of type integer. With the next statement, we are assigning the base address of array A in a variable j. Base address is nothing but the name of the array. Name of array itself is a starting address or a base address of the array, and it is pointing to the first element of the array. With this for loop, for I to I is less than 5, we are displaying the value available at the address location j plus I. What is this? This j plus I is nothing but the formula is like value available at the base address plus the index location. The same thing is used over here to display the content of the array with the help of pointer variable. How this program will work? Let's go forward. In this diagram, array is declared. with all its 5 indices and its values. These are the address location at which the data is stored. Array is a linear data structure, that's why continuous memory is allotted to this array. How this program works? Now let's start with a J variable. J is a pointer type variable holding the address location. J plus the index I is equal to 0. It is holding the address of the first element of the array, that is A of 0, and its address. So it is pointing to the first element of the array, and value available at this address location is nothing but 1. So with the help of this printf statement, 1 is displayed. Go forward. For the next iteration, I will become 1, condition is true, and J, that is base address plus 1, it will point to the next address location. The next address location is 65512. How the next address location could be 65512 instead of 65511? Now in this case, the compiler calculates the next address location. As the J is a pointer type variable and plus 1 is nothing but to go to the next address location. J is holding the address of type integer variable, and here 2 bytes are required to store the data of type integer. So to go to next address location, it goes to 65512. It indicates that base address plus 1 is nothing but go for the next address location. And compiler internally adds that many number of bytes required to store the data of type integer, that is nothing but 2 bytes in this example. So that's why it goes to 65512. And now at this moment, it is pointing to the index 1 and holding the value 2. So this printf statement will display 2 as the next value as the output for the iteration. If we'll go forward, for this J plus 2, it will go to next address location 65514, and it will display the value available at the index position 2. And in this way, the loop will get executed. With every iteration, the value will get displayed, and at the end, the output of this program will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, let's go forward. Like, if instead of J plus I, or value at the address J plus I, we'll use value at the address A plus I, what will be the output of the program? Can we use like this or not? And if we can use, what will be the output of the program? Move to the next slide. Here, this slide will explain the answer to the previous question. Now let's go forward for a program where we are using value at the address A plus I. Now the same thing is declared over here, only the difference is instead of value at the address J plus I from the previous program, we are using value at the address A plus I. What is this A plus I? Now A is nothing but the name of the array, and name of the array is nothing but the base address of the array. As all of you are knowing, array name behaves like a constant pointer and points to the very first element of the array, and we are making use of this feature to store or to access all the elements of array with the help of its base address. Here, what will be the output of this program? Now we'll move to the program to check the output, where the same program is written over here. Array A is declared with 5 values. for loop is used over here, and here we are displaying the content of a of I and at the same time the value available at the address a plus I. Now let's check what is the output of this program. It is executing and here the output is a of 0 is equal to 1, as well as for value at the address a of a plus 0 is also equal to 1. For the remaining iterations 1, 2, 3, 4, it is displaying the values 2, 3, 4 and 5 respectively for both the examples. Now, here with the help of value at the address base address plus I, we can access all the elements of the array. In previous slide only, we have used a pointer type variable j with which we are performing a task, but in this example we are not going to use any pointer type variable. Note is given over here, no any pointer variable is declared, all tasks are done with the name of the array itself. Is there any another way with which we can access pointer to 1D arrays? Yes, the another way is, in this program we have declared, we have assigned a pointer type variable j with the base address of array A. With the printf statement, we are displaying value available at the address j by performing j++ every time. J++ again, the compiler internally goes to the next address locations according to the data type of which address we are going to store in a pointer type variable. In this case, it is assumed that 2 bytes are required to store the integer type data. That's why with the every increment in j, it will get incremented by 2 address location, and obviously it will point to the next address location in every iteration. Let's look here, which will explain every iteration of the for loop. Very first time, j is assigned with the base address or a starting address of array, and it is pointing to the same address location and it will display 1 over here. By going forward, the next j++ is performed, increment in j, and the next address location 65512 is assigned to j, and it will point to the same address location to display the value available at the address location. Again j++, it will point to next address location 65514, and it will display the contents available at that address location. Next statement j++, next address location is 65516, and it will display the next value available at the address location, that is nothing but 4. Last time j++, 65518, the next address location, it will point to next address location and it will display the value available at this address location. At the end, simultaneously the I++ is also performed, and the checking condition is I is less than 5. At this moment, after performing J++ as well as I++, the condition is false and it will get exited from a for loop. In this way, it will display 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sequentially as the output of this program. In these three different ways, we can access pointer to 1D arrays. At the end of this slide, I am concluding this session, as in these three different ways, we can use pointer to 1D arrays. How to implement pointer to 2D arrays, we'll see in next session. Thank you.